Richard Southern joins us to chat about some of the day's more unusual stories. And we start with a food mascot getting mistaken for a UFO.
Yeah, I mean, you and I have covered the UFO story, ins and the outs of it the last year. And, you know, the U.S. government says, yeah, we think we're tracking things. We don't know what they are. But some UFOs are more interesting than others, Erica. I want to show you one that was spotted last weekend over Mississauga, right here in the GTA. And that kind of looks a little creepy, doesn't it, Erica?
Yeah, I don't know what that is. I can understand.
Could it be the aliens, or the aliens maybe want to go to square one?
It might be, yes. Malls are open.
Anyways, it was posted to two UFO YouTube channels last weekend in Mississauga, but some local residents said, hey, we know what this is. It's not a UFO. It's not an alien. It's, in fact, Mr. Peanut. It's a Mr. Peanut balloon, an advertisement, Erica. There he is.
Yes, we know Mr. Peanut very well. Not an alien at all. Very friendly. Okay.
He's got his top hat, his monocle,
very
his cane.
Proper. Dapper?
So stand down. No aliens in Mississauga. Just cute old Mr. Peanut.
Oh, man. Sorry, guys. No aliens this time.
Sorry.
But
much to my dismay, Erica, you know.
Okay. And this has been talked about a lot on social media. There's a new social media challenge that's getting plenty of attention and for all the wrong reasons. Definitely don't try this one at home, Richard.
No, please do not try this at home. But we want to talk about it because doctors are coming out and warning against it. It's called the milk crate challenge. And it involves using those milk crates to build like a little pyramid structure that you're supposed to walk up one side of and walk down the other without falling over. But people do fall over,
oh,
and that's
goodness.
The problem right now.
Yeah.
The doctors say it can be a very dangerous fall. There's nothing to brace yourself on. It's worse than falling off a ladder. So the milk crate challenge, you're going to see
this
it.
One, but she's doing it in heels? Sorry, oh, my goodness. Okay, milk crates with, okay. Go on.
You get bonus points for doing it in the heels, Erica. Hey, but, you know, speaking of TikTok, I want to bring up something you have done, because Erica has just signed up for the TikTok video service.
I did.
And her first, this is how talented she is. It doesn't surprise me. Her first video has blown up. Tell us about it,
Erica. I was so shocked. Yeah, so I'm finally on TikTok. My first post, I decided to do like a behind the scenes on how we do a live news flash. And it got attention for a very particular reason, but have a look.
BTS, what I hear in my earpiece during a live news flash.
2-1 Q.
Breaking news this hour, an Ontario MPP is facing expulsion from caucus.
4-3-2-1 Nailed it.
So, Richard, you saw at the end there, Jared, who's directing right now, he counts me down, and he actually counts as I'm, you know, saying the last lines of the news flash. And a lot of people were so amazed by that because it can be very distracting, yes, but we're so used to it. I didn't realize that people would sort of think that was weird.
You were a pro at it, Erica. You were a pro. And Jared is a great director. He's he's always in our ears, but he's telling us what to do and what not to do. He's great at doing that.
And I must say, you know, it is distracting, but I need to hear that because I need to know how much time I have left, right? And he paces me out, right?
And how many views does this have on TikTok now?
This has 200,000 plus views. It's got, you know, 19,000 likes. It's pretty crazy. But I mean, I would love to show more behind the scenes stuff. Richard, you should get on TikTok as well.
I would ruin it. I'd destroy your views, Erica.
No,
but listen, don't forget to send the elevator back down to Richie now that you're TikTok famous. Don't forget about me.
Listen,
okay?
That is nothing. In the TikTok world, that's just a drop in the bucket. Nothing.
I love it.
Nailed it, Jared says. Okay, thanks, Richard. We'll see you again tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.